Makrato Katoko sote kelia dadakata eklato sote kesia dadakata katasa lebroko shoto kotosi kabala kate katia. I want to specially welcome everybody to the prayer mountain. Maka sote lebreke teke shota kata yada imbrala dagadoko seke telebrege degedo shakata ye balada kato shote ke baradi yada dakate manando kose ibla kato shete ke riada dadadadada embloko soto pala kato sheke teke liada. I'd like you to begin to pray in the Holy Spirit. Maka po shata kato seke telebrege degedi yada dadakada. Welcome to the prayer mountain. I want you to know that men that pray, men of prayer are not perfect men, but they are men who understand how to connect with the perfect God. Open your mouth and pray in the Holy Ghost. It's a new day. It's a new day. Men of prayer are men and people who know how to change things in the realm of the spirit. They are believers. They are Christians. Who know how to connect with the unusual, with the supernatural God. I'd like you to understand, it is not only Christians that pray. There are so many other people that pray. But who do they pray to? They pray, if the person they pray to, if the deity they pray to, if the image they pray to has not been answering them, they will not continue to pray to that image. There is a spirit that they pray to. There is a spirit when they pray, they may have an idol in front of them, but when they pray, there is a spirit behind that idol that connects with them. And so also we as believers, when we engage prayer, we are connected to supernatural. We are connected to the Almighty God. We are connected to the Ancient of Days. We are connected to the Spirit of Judgment Make Perfect. And the Akata. We are connected to the Holy Jerusalem. We are connected to the tabernacle and the company and the assembly of the firstborn. We are connected to Zion. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Eklado shata katayada rebregedo zose kete bodo imana kota kadiada da leketo zose kete baraka toskita meblegedo zoka pakata yeke soto lo bregedie diada dagada rebregia ladoga shuma ladiada gade yeke soto palika toskete liana manda ibragado goshe kete liada gabada lebregedegediada dagada gada mekleto soto koboshe keliada dabada men da. Things happen in their life. Children that become great and become reference point for good things, you know, in their lives. There are men that they are children that their parents spend time in the altar, spend time on their knees praying, spend time in prayers and presenting them before God. Say, God, this is my son. God, this is my daughter. God, this is my child. God, these children did not just become great. We wonder, we don't know their father. We don't know their mother. Yeah, their father died in the place of prayer. Their mother died in the place of prayer. It was prayer that they lived their life. They led their prayer life. They prayed as a way of sacrificing their life for those children to become what they are. It is prayer. It is prayer. That's what I'm talking about. That is why the prayer mountain is important. If you are spending 30 minutes, you know you are firing prayer. Pray in the Holy Ghost. I have always heard people say, you don't need prayer to for your business to be good. You don't need prayer for you to be, you just need wisdom. Do you understand that prayer is the engine room of wisdom? Prayer generates spiritual things. Prayer generates divine things, supernatural things, supernatural happenings around our life, because it connects you with with the divine. Ando koso keliadada bakasha. Breketo koso tolo brakata kata. Ikano jekatiada la bagada. Le kregedo koso te paliada kata. Ikato je manani agadaka. Le keso to barakati da bada. Ye brogodo godo sekete. Ye ma karadia da lagada yada. Ye klado shakato badiana nakate. Ye zabalado go shekete liada dagada yada. Beke soto baliana nakata. Igaragado zekete le bregedo kosha. Mando go so bladege digi dimanda. Ye plakato zoso kotolo bregedege liada dabada. Ye breke soto koto koto. Prayer is one. Commitment to prayer is one major test. I'm a pastor, I'm an overseer by the grace of God, not just by title, but by the grace of God. I am an overseer. I always tell my pastors and my ministers, I say, you may be a seer. You may be a seer, but I am an overseer. You know, I tell them, I say, one of the tests for them that I always present to them is the test of prayer. Is the test of prayer. We just rounded up. I just closed my eyes and I slept by 3 a.m. And I am up again. And we are on the prayer mountain. I tell them, I always monitor. I watch. Now I am watching. I'm like, which of them showed up? Which of them came for prayer mountain this morning? It is my own way of testing. Maybe they went from work and they went to VG, and from VG to prayer, and then, oh, they are tired now. And that is my own test. I look for those. Is this one quickly tired? Is this one tired of connecting prayer? Huh. It is personally, it's not God that is using it to test, but it is personally, I use it, I'm watching. Is this person still on? You know, and genuinely, they may just be tired because it has been from one program to another program to another program. But as an overseer, I do not see it like that. I look for that person. I look for that minister. I look for that worker. I look for that Christian. I look for that son, that daughter. Oh, we say, man, what is this body doing on this bed? Get up and let's go to the mountain to pray. Makato Zelia Dabada. This morning, I will read a scripture to you. We shall be praying a prayer I titled, No Public Tears. Remember, when we prayed some time ago last week, I raised prayer about no tears. This one, I am going to be praying prayer that I titled, No Public Tears. You know, in 1 Samuel chapter 30, if you look at verse 4, the Bible says, and David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept until they had no more power to weep. And then if you look at verse 2, the wives and the women and the children and all of them have been carried away and they have been taken captive. So in verse 4, the men that just returned from battle, the people that came with David, plus David himself, they lifted up their voices and they began to weep. They began to cry. And the Akasata, in Mark chapter 5, the story of the man with the unclean spirit. The man with the unclean spirit. Remember that story? We are still hammering prayers on that. We are still drawing prayers from that man's life. In verse 5, he said, and always, night and day, he was in the mountain. So the demons were walking without taking a break. And they were not tired. Night and day, he was in the mountains. Take note of the word mountains again. He was in the mountains and in the tombs. He was crying, cutting himself with stones. The man with the unclean spirit, according to this scripture, was often in the mountains. But what was he doing in the mountains? Crying. Andoko shakatia da la bagadaya. He had the capacity to rise to the mountain, but all he did in that place, in that mountain, all he did there was to cry. He got strategic positioning, and it came with tears. He got strategic positioning, but they came with tears. He was positioned in a high place that helped to advertise his tears for everybody to see. That is why I said no public tears. He was positioned in a place. This place was, this place was supposed to project him for something better, but he did the opposite. This place helped to position him in a place to advertise his tears. Who wants to publicize their tears? Who wants to advertise their tears? Nobody. He was in a place where his tears could not be hidden. That is what I'm talking about. His tears could not be hidden. He was, what he may have preferred to call private tears became public tears. Do you get my point here? Beloved, every attack of the enemy that want to cause you to shed public tears, you know, I don't know what is going on. Any projection, any attack of the enemy that want to cause you to shed public tears, today I cancel it. Today, I cancel them in the precious name of Jesus. Let the Lord arise and scuttle every evil plot of the enemy, every evil plot of the kingdom of darkness. Let the Lord arise and scuttle them. Let it scuttle them. Any power that want to make you shed public tears, no, I reject them for you. I reject them for myself in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let the Lord arise against every challenge. Every challenge that wants you to be mocked in public spaces. And I just prayed for somebody now. I just believe that prayer is exactly for somebody. Let the Lord arise now against every challenge that wants you to be mocked in public spaces. Right now, in the name of Jesus, the Bible talks about the man who brought the son to Jesus, and he said, please heal my son, pray, cure my son. And he said, sometimes the father's description of that boy's condition was that sometimes in public places, this evil spirit will throw him down. He will disgrace and embarrass. He said, even in public spaces, can I pray for someone now? In the name that is above every other name, let the Lord arise against every trouble that want to make you a negative spectacle. In the name of Jesus, every form of trouble that want to make you a negative spectacle, let the Lord arise against them now. Let the Lord arise against them now. You are a royal priesthood. You are a peculiar nation. You have been called out of darkness. You have entered into his marvelous light to show forth the praises of God. In the name of Jesus, let the Lord arise against every public disgrace. Ana megada roko shote kesia dabada leki tamado gada. There are some names that people are called. Some people are called today. You know, that name is a name of public disgrace. I remember one boy. One boy. His name surprised me. I asked, what is your name? He said, my name is College. I said, how can your name be College? How can your name be College? At this point in time, this young man, nothing was working for him. From one complaint to another, his name was College. I said, what? Go and find out. Your name cannot be College. How can somebody just give birth to a child and say your name is College? Are you school? What happened? And then he went to find out and discover that his mother got pregnant while she was still in college. And nobody claimed that pregnancy. They denied the pregnancy. They said, this boy said, I'm not responsible for your pregnancy. Do you understand that when they gave back to this boy, they said, well, let's give him the name. Which name? His name is College. It was the father to the girl, the father to the mother that called him College, because it was a shame to the whole family. It was a disgrace to the whole family. And since then, even this boy was growing as a young man, he did not even know the history behind his name. Can I pray for somebody here in the name of Jesus? Let the Lord arise against every public disgrace, when you remember it, it brings disgrace, it brings bad memories. Today, let the blood of Jesus wipe it away in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. It was bad enough that the man with the unclean spirit was laboring under affliction. Are you getting my point? It was bad enough. He was laboring under affliction, but it became worse when everyone had to see his tears whenever he cried. They said he has started again. He has started again. He's crying again. When he begins to cry, nobody can pass that way. When he begins to cry, everybody is saying, oh God, what is it this time around? He disturbs the neighborhood. People look at him, they say, we want to help him, but how can we help him? With some people, they say, but we've helped him before, but the thing didn't work. I pray for someone under the sound of my voice. Thus saith the Lord of hosts himself, every attempt of the enemy to make bad matters in your life to become worse, let the Lord arise and scatter them. Let the Lord arise and scatter them. Who am I praying for? Let the Lord arise and scatter them in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Every plot of the enemy to make your secret tears to become public tears, I command it to end now. Let that plot scatter. Let that plot be scuttled in the name of Jesus Christ. I command your secret tears to be halted now. No secret tears, no public tears. No secret tears, no public tears. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Do you know something? Jesus was made manifest so that he will destroy the works of the devil. He will destroy sickness. He will destroy pain. He will destroy trouble and torture. He will destroy failure. He will destroy this public embarrassment in the name of Jesus. These negative tendencies, I command their power to break and their yokes destroyed now. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. If there be any works of darkness that is causing tears in your life, I command it to cease now. I command it to cease now. I command them to cease now. I command them to end now. Sister, I'm praying for you. I command that works of darkness to end now. Now, now, now. All good and all perfect gift cometh from above, from the Father of light, in whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. If you see and trace any works of darkness in your life that causes tears, as I pray now, I command them to end. I command the tears to be over. I command them to cease. I command the struggles to end in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Can I pray this prayer for somebody? There are three people I'm praying this prayer for. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I command every source of secret and public tears to dry up. Their source, their source, their source. I command it to dry up in the name of Jesus. There are some families, people don't really live so old. You see, their mother died early. Their daddy died early. Their uncle died early. Their auntie died early. Their so-and-so died early. Any negative trend in that family, from as I am praying for you now, I decree and declare you, your children, your husband, your wife, you are exempted. You are separated from that negative cause, from that negative operation right now in the name of Jesus. I say you are separated by fire, by power. You are untouchable. You know what he said, touch not my anointed. That is who you are. He was talking about you. Touch not my anointed. You are the anointed of God. I decree today, your children will live to full old age. You will see them grow before your eyes. You will see them marry before your eyes. You will see your own grandchildren. Ah, my God. You will see them and you will see your great-grandchildren. You say, like this? I have seen grandchildren enough. You will see the great-grandchildren in the name of Jesus Christ. As I pray, so shall it be. As I pray, let it begin to happen. Let it begin to happen. Let it begin to happen. Can I pray one more prayer for somebody here? I shut every door. You know, doors can be open and doors can be closed and it can be shut. I shut every door that is inviting issues that will cause you to cry in public. Who am I praying this one for now? Lord, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit. Every door that is inviting issues. You know, there are some things that will happen in the life of somebody. Before he knows that he himself is crying or she herself is crying, you will be one, the tears have dropped. It's just like a reflex action. The tears will be coming that she will not even know. He will not even know. You are the one I'm praying this one for now. I shut every door that is inviting issues. There are doors that invite issues. Issues that will cause you to cry in the public. I close that door now in the name of Jesus. I close the door. I say I close it now in the name of Jesus. You are the one I'm praying for. I close that door now. In the name of Jesus, now I'm closing another door. Every door that is attracting negativity that will cause embarrassment in the public. God Almighty, God Almighty, embarrassment, negative. You know, doors that are attracting negativity. Close it now in the name of Jesus. I shut the door. There is one more door I need to shut now. I shut every door of negative emergency. Doors of negative emergencies. Who am I praying this one for? Doors of negative emergencies. Adeke liya badakata. Lebregedo kosoto kubayada. Reke soko tobliedi adakata. Negative emergency. They say, what has happened again? Is that one? I shut the door in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. E kato zege dia Holy Spirit. Thank you for this one. Thank you for this one. This one just came. Malia dedeko shatakata. This one just came. Every door. Kado bieke to soto koto shiede liada. Every public tears and embarrassment and disgrace that comes on the day of somebody's joy. Oh my God. Oh my God. Every public tears and disgrace and embarrassment that show up on the day of somebody's joy. Today I command that door close. I command that embarrassment destroyed, canceled by fire. In the name of Jesus. Ikaboshote liadagada, mekasoto lebregediadada. The days of public tears and public shame and public embarrassment, they are over in your life. You are the one I just prayed for. They are over in your life, brother. You are the one I just prayed for. They are over in your life in the name of Jesus. The days of public tears, public shame, public embarrassment, they are over in your life. They are over in my life. They are over in our lives. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, no longer shall negativity follow you into public spaces. So many years ago, I watched a movie. This movie taught me a lot of, you know, when something teaches you a lot of sense, a lot of wisdom, you don't forget it so easily. So many years ago, I saw this movie. Since the day of the naming of the christening, the naming ceremony of this little when this guy was a baby, this evil spirit was always moving with him. He was following him everywhere. He didn't see the evil spirit, no other person. Only those people with spiritual eyes sees that evil spirit. You know, even if he's in the marketplaces, everywhere, if he's sleeping, the evil spirit will stand there and stand by the side. He doesn't sleep. The evil spirit doesn't go to anywhere. Where he goes is where the evil spirit goes. I want to pray for you. That devil is a liar. Any monitoring spirit that has monitored you from village to village to university, back to he enter inside the plane with you. He enter into today. To now, as I pray, I set them on fire in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost chase them far away from you. Whatever connection you people have, I disconnect them now. Now, you and that evil spirit, I don't care the agreement they did when you were a baby. I disconnect them now. In the name of Jesus, they are disconnected. They are disconnected from you. I repeat the prayer I pray for you again. No longer shall any negativity follow you into public spaces. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, in the victorious name of Jesus Christ, in the victorious name of Jesus Christ, they say the thing just embarrass him. The thing just disgrace him. No, not you anymore. They used to do it before. From this mountain of prayer now, I say no more embarrassment, no more shame, no more negativity in public spaces, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. In Psalm 61 verse 1 and 2, I want to pray this last prayer for you before we round up on the prayer mountain today. Psalms chapter 61 verse 1 and 2, it says, hear my cry, O God, attend unto my prayer. From the ends of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. I repeat it again. Hear my cry, oh God. Attend unto my prayer. From the ends of the earth, I don't care where they buried it. From the ends of the earth, I don't care the village they did it. From the ends of the earth, I don't care the boardroom where it was organized. From the ends of the earth, I don't care the coven and the convent where it was planned. From the ends of the earth, I don't care the boundary where they buried it, where they did it. From the ends of the earth, I don't care the middle of the night where the pronouncements were made. From the ends of the earth, I don't care whether the person that did it is dead and buried and gone, but the effects continue. From the ends of the earth today, I cry on your behalf and on my behalf. I cry unto the Almighty God. I cry unto the God of Jeshurun. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I, that is higher than I, that is higher than I. You are secured from today. You are protected from today. In the name of Jesus, no more public tears, no more private tears. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, David, stop weeping. David, tell your men to stop crying. Hey, Barakatia Dagada, Sado the ass. Get ready, pursue them, overtake them. Without fail, you will recover all. 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 Who is this person that is making me to keep saying this thing? You will recover all. You will recover all. You will recover all. You may lost it before. You may have lost it before. You may have lost it when you were in sin. You may have lost it when you were in carelessness. You may have lost it when you didn't know what you were really doing. You may have lost it when you were still playing games. You may have lost it in the university. You may have lost it in the home. You may have lost it in the village. You may have lost it when you spoke anyhow to that man of God. You may have lost it when you spoke anyhow to your parents. You may have lost it when you disobeyed your parents. Today, recover all. Recover the lost glory. Recover the lost honor. Recover the lost honor. Recover the lost glory. You lost it when you disappointed that person you promised you will marry after he spent all the money, but yet you disappointed, and the person became very hot, and the person said, oh, you have done this to me, and the person made some pronouncement. Yes, it may have happened in the past, but today the glory you lost, let them be restored. The honor you lost, let them be restored. By the mercies of the God of Jeshurun, let them be restored. 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 The mistakes of your yesterday that is trying to raise their head today in order to cough public tears, I silence those mistakes now. I erase and eradicate them. The blood of Jesus speaketh better, 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 better things than the blood of judgment, than the blood of Abel. I decree today, by the blood of Jesus, let every penalty you were supposed to pay and continue to pay, your children were supposed to continue to pay them, I decree now, by the blood of Jesus, let those penalty be canceled. The penalty is canceled by the blood of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, so shall it be. So shall it be. So shall it be. So it is now. So it is tomorrow. So it will be forever. You are free. You are liberated. No more public tears. No more public tears. No more private tears. No more secret tears. In the name of Jesus, those pain that you cannot explain to somebody, those issues you cannot explain to people, no more, no more, no more. Receive miracle. Receive your testimony. Receive your breakthrough. Receive your breakthrough. Receive your breakthrough. You are the one. You are the one. You are the one. Your head will not reject prayer. Your head will not reject prophecy. Your head will not reject prophecy. Your head will not reject prayer. Oh yeah, receive your breakthrough. Oh yeah, receive your miracle. Let your money that are tied be released to you. Let your favor that are tied be released to you now in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh my God, I worship you. Begin to worship him. Begin to give him praise and glory. Honor him. I give you glory, Lord. I give you honor. Blessed be your name forever. He came down that we may have life. He came down that we may have life. Jesus came down that we may have life, eternal life, more abundantly. Hey, he came down that we may have life. Oh yes, he came down that we may have life. Jesus came down that we may have life. Hey, eternal life more abundantly. Ah, he came down that we may have life. Hallelujah. He came down that we may have life. Jesus came down that we may have life. Eternal life more abundantly. Yadaka shabadaga diadadabada. Legadegebo shandiadadabayada. We worship you. We give you praise. We give you glory, Lord.